welcome to the Tips for Networking at the Grace Hopper Celebration. In this video, we're going to discuss ways in which you can network and meet people at the conference, as well as how to prepare yourself before you leave for the event. Remember, Grace Hopper offers two events in one, a world-renowned professional development conference where you can learn about anything from career planning to artificial intelligence to robotics, and where you will meet and connect with people while you're attending your chosen sessions. The other event is the largest career fair in the world for women technologists, where hundreds of organizations would like to talk with you about the opportunities they have available, which may be just what you're looking for as you start your internship, full-time career, or go on to further your studies in a graduate or PhD program. So, congratulations on attending the conference, and let's get ready. The Anita Borg Institute has created a terrific mobile app for you to use to plan your schedule ahead of time and review the organizations in the career fair. Here are some steps to include in your planning before the conference. Prepare and print your resumes and get printed business cards to hand out to people you meet. Download the Grace Hopper Celebration mobile app to find the sessions you want to attend. You can also connect with people on the mobile app before, at, and after the conference. Highlight the organizations at the career fair you're interested in talking with about your future. There will be companies, nonprofits, government agencies, and laboratories, as well as universities if you would like to continue your education. The companies represent many different industries such as technology, retail, media and entertainment, financial services, insurance, and even startups. Research those organizations you would like to talk with. There are very large companies hiring women like yourself. However, don't forget many mid-size and smaller companies are also very exciting to work for, and they are interested in talking with you. Map out your time in the career fair so you have enough time to meet with people at your targeted organizations over the 3 days of the conference. Prepare your opening questions. Most of the people at the company booths will be recruiters. However, you may run across women technologists and even some executives, both male and female. Be sure to ask thoughtful questions after you introduce yourself. For example, what plans does your company have in place for increasing gender diversity over the next few years? Lastly, develop your elevator speech, a short blurb about yourself that tells someone who you are, and develop your personal brand. Practice in front of a mirror or in front of others until you feel comfortable. At the career fair, the first 5 seconds is key. Even if the company is casual and all the people in the booth are in jeans and t-shirts, still dress professionally. You only have one first impression, so make it a good one. Dress professionally not only for the career fair and interviews, but always during the conference. However, be sure to wear comfortable shoes since you'll be walking quite a bit. Visit smaller booths since there may not be as much competition, yet great jobs at these companies. A professionally dressed candidate with a firm handshake and an interesting opening question will make a hit. Be yourself, be friendly, and smile. When you meet people during your sessions or lunch, or even in the elevators, ask them where they're from, how they're enjoying the conference, what they'll do or have been doing while there, and introduce yourself. After even a brief conversation, ask a question like, "May I get in touch with you to find out more about your company?" Note their name or ask for their business card so you can follow up after the conference directly or on LinkedIn or the mobile app. You never know who might be looking for a candidate like you for an open position. When attending a presentation, panel, or workshop, listen intently, and if you come up with questions, jot them down for the Q&A if they have it. If you have a question during the Q&A, keep it succinct and relevant to the presentation. After the session, if possible, introduce yourself to the speaker and tell them one thing you picked out that you enjoyed or got you thinking. Thank the presenter, ask if you can get in touch to find out more about their organization or the topic. If appropriate, offer a business card or ask for theirs. At all times, again, be professional and grateful to all you connect with. Keep notes on whom you have met, connect with them on the mobile app as soon as possible after the meeting so they remember you. Once again, remember there are women from over 80 countries attending, so take advantage of this opportunity to connect. You never know who your next best friend may be in a country far away. Encourage others, share what you've learned, refer people to organizations you may have talked with, eat lunch with someone new, and enjoy this special time. After the conference, have a blast at the Friday night celebration. Dance and enjoy. You deserve it. This is your time to celebrate the great job you've been doing for the past 3 days, learning, connecting, communicating, and creating opportunities for yourself to expand and broaden your horizons. If you get a chance, talk with someone in the booths of the Friday night sponsors. Don't forget to follow up and thank all those you met, whether directly, on the mobile app, or on LinkedIn. And for the companies you talked with and or have had interviews, continue to do research to prepare you for any further phone or in-person interviews. Follow the organization's website, social media, and press releases. They may have opportunities just right for you in the future, if not now. One last thing. Before she created the Grace Hopper Celebration, Anita Borg started a private email network of women in technology called Sisters that now has over 7,000 members throughout the world. You can join for free and have many more connections of women technologists like yourself. In summary, here is a quick list of do's and don'ts to follow while at Grace Hopper. Don't put too much pressure on yourself. Be prepared and go for it the best you can. Don't hide behind your cell phone, the mobile app, or the pocket guide or literature. Don't make the conference all about getting giveaways. This may be a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for you. Don't get discouraged or give up. You will find the opportunities either at Grace Hopper or in your future by developing your network and continuing to stay positive. Believe that perfect next step is out there waiting for you. Practice networking, introducing yourself, and creating questions to ask people when you meet them. Prepare ahead of time, manage your time, be organized, and take breaks. Relax and smile. Think, what do I have to lose when meeting people? Most people want to meet you and get to know something about you. That's why they're here. Follow up in whatever way you can with those you have met. Keep in touch with friends you've made. On behalf of all of us, we look forward to meeting you at the Grace Hopper Celebration.